I think the first of all, the Friday and Saturday weekends is exclusively for the government departments, the state government departments, and for the private sector, they can choose whether they want to be Friday, Saturday, or they want to be maintained as Saturday, Sunday. We must understand that practically everything, if you look at the ports, for example, it is already a privatized entity. You know, it's private sector. The airport is also run by the private sector. So they can choose. And they are not binded or they're not compelled to have Friday and Saturday as their weekends, right? So I don't see the worry of the private sector in saying, oh, if there is Friday, Saturday for the government, we will have a problem. Whereas in fact, they will be open on Sunday, right? The government will be open on Sunday. The government departments will be open. The state government departments in particular will open on Sunday. So they can still deal with the state government. The only issue is what will happen to, say, for example, the federal government departments, like the customs, right? But customs they have no problem. I think they can always follow how the ports, the weekend that is decided by the ports, the weekends decided by the immigration, right? Because this is being a standing practice by government that we adjust to the requirements of the people, right? I mean, it doesn't mean that just because Friday, Saturday is going to be a government weekend in Johor Bahru, that there won't be any immigration officials at the causeway, you know? I mean, at the CIQ. I mean, it is okay, it's all right that people should sound off their alarm. But it is also important for them to sit back and think it through. The only problem that will arise is that KL, Putrajaya, for example, will have Saturday, Sunday as the weekends. And then, of course, Friday and Saturday are weekends in Johor Bahru, in Johor, the state of Johor. Meetings that federal government may want to do with the state government may have to be done on Sundays. But it does not mean that if Putrajaya calls for a meeting on Friday, that the senior government officials from Johor State will say, no, we can't attend the meeting because it is our rest day. That's not true. I mean, we don't have to be too dramatic about the impact of this weekend. And I think basically, as a state that has been used to have this weekend, and then now is being restored as the state weekend, state government's weekend. I think it is a matter that we'll adjust to. That's number one. Number two, for Johor Bahru in particular, we are a border town, border to Singapore, and it is in our nature to have a 24/7 practice, of working maybe 7 days a week or having a 24-hour availability of the facilities in Johor Bahru, especially.
There was one comment I had. This guy saying like, actually, I may have one day less with my family.
Yeah, there will be problems like that when your wife works in the school, for example, or in the state government. The husband works in the federal in the private sector. Or federal department which has not chosen to go the same way. Maybe there's a problem that they have, a split weekend, right? They will have the one of them having Friday off, and then the other one having Sunday off. So they will only have Saturday as a common weekend. But basically, I assume that most people will adjust to it.